Słuchasz podcastu Agni, Ajurweda zrozumiale i dostępnie, odcinek 76. Listopad jest czasem szczególnym dla nas, bo zawsze w listopadzie świętujemy kolejną rocznicę prowadzenia Agni i w tym roku jest to 8. rocznica, odkąd Agni działa, tworzy i pomaga ludziom skorzystać z Ajurwedy. W tym roku świętujemy również 1. rocznicę podcastu. Pierwszy odcinek ukazał się 3 listopada 2020 roku. No i wow, minął już dobry rok, odkąd zaczęłam regularne nagrywanie odcinków. I cieszę się bardzo z tej formy, którą przyjęłam, pozwalając sobie na eksperymentowanie z podcastem, na twórcze poszukiwania tego, w jaki sposób chcę prowadzić tą audycję. Bardzo się cieszę ze wszystkich rozmów ze zwyczajnymi kobietami, które weszły na ścieżkę Ajurwedy. Potrzebujemy więcej takich historii, takich świadectw, nie tylko od tych osób, które lśnią jak gwiazdy na scenie Ajurwedy, ale też od tych osób, które lśnią na scenie swojego życia i na scenie swoich rodzin. Także rozmów ze zwyczajnymi, niezwyczajnymi kobietami zajmującymi się Ajurwedą zdecydowanie będzie w ramach tego podcastu zawsze pod dostatkiem, bo bardzo to lubię. I cenię sobie rolę kogoś, kto prowadzi te niezwykłe kobiety przed szersze grono. A dzisiaj odcinek w konwencji Gość pyta. Zaprosiłam Elizabeth Engel, która od 2 lat jest moją coachką, do tego, żeby porozmawiała ze mną i podsumowała szczególnie ostatni rok, ostatnie 2 lata, odkąd zaczęłyśmy współpracować w kontekście tego, co się we mnie zmieniło, co we mnie rozwinęło się tak, że ma to swoje odzwierciedlenie w biznesie, który prowadzę, bo jestem głęboko przekonana o tym, że biznes rozwija się tak bardzo, jak rozwijasz się ty sama. Jest to rozmowa w języku angielskim. Bardzo serdecznie zapraszam cię do posłuchania tego. Rozmowy, które prowadzę z Elizabeth, mają ten cudny, spokojny flow, kiedy z bardzo spokojnym umysłem udaje mi się dobrze i trafnie oddać to, co czuję i co myślę o prowadzeniu Agni i o rozwoju w ramach Ajurwedy. Serdecznie zapraszam do posłuchania. Witam Cię w podcaście Agni, Ajurweda zrozumiale i dostępnie. Nazywam się Maria Nowak-Szabat. Wspólnie z mężem Michałem od 7 lat prowadzę Agni Ajurweda. Pomagam kobietom skorzystać z Ajurwedy w życiu osobistym i zawodowym. W każdym odcinku otworzysz serce i umysł na tą piękną, starożytną wiedzę o życiu. Posłuchasz o niej w zrozumiały sposób. Poznasz inspirujące kobiety, które przeszły swoją przemianę z Ajurwedą. W tym podcaście będę także dzielić się moimi odkryciami i obserwacjami. Dzięki temu poczujesz się wzmocniona i gotowa do wcielania w życie zmian, których pragnie Twoja dusza. Ajurweda jest prosta, ale jej zrozumienie i zastosowanie w codziennym życiu wymaga wsparcia. Od zawsze była przekazywana w relacji nauczyciel-uczeń w formie otwierających serce i umysł opowieści. Bardzo się cieszę, że mogę się z Tobą podzielić moją pasją i doświadczeniem z 7 lat pracy w tym obszarze. Cieszę się, że spędzisz ten czas ze mną i starą, mądrą Ajurwedą. Hello, Elizabeth. So glad to have you for the second time in my podcast. Thank you for coming here.
Hello, Maria. So nice to see you. And thank you very much for your invitation.
And this time in unusual role, the role that I really love about my podcast, which means that you will be asking questions.
Exactly. We're talking about your really tremendous development during the past 2 years or also earlier and see what brought you where you are today.
Mm-hmm. So before we will dive in into this journey that we went through together, it's nearly 2 years. Could you please say who you are and what you do?
Yes. So I am Elizabeth Engel. I live in Germany, close to Frankfurt. I'm an energy coach, a spiritual life and business coach, and I show high-achieving women entrepreneurs who feel tired, how they find back into their full power, so they can bring their successful business to the next level and really live in their zone of genius. Mm. And I'm working with them on their beliefs, to break through limiting beliefs, to transform their beliefs, so they get supported by what they believe about themselves and really transform not only their beliefs, this transforms your life. When you mm-hmm. get aware of what you're thinking and what you're believing about yourself, about others, about your situation. And when you change this, this really changes your whole life and also your business.
So true. Yeah, I've experienced this working with you. And I remember that I was attracted to this quality of light, being light in the meaning that not, you know, opposite to heavy. The lightness that you were sharing during your stories about working with clients. And then when I saw you in person, this lightness around you, like the colorful and bright smiling energy, this was something that I was like, yes, I want more of this.
Thank you. How would you describe yourself when we started working together? And how did you feel at that time? Where was your business? What were your goals?
It's, you know, it's funny enough because we met in the circle of our previous mentor and Sigrun. And Sigrun is, and I was with her very like goal oriented. So it was all about numbers and achievements. And usually the recipe for success was very easy with her. And for quite a long time, I found it really effective. But then I reached the wall. And the wall was the wall of beliefs, the things in me that they are asking me to do certain things or to do the things in a certain way, sometimes in a way that really brings more tiredness and more suffering. And it's not so light and easy and flowing. And I already had like those bold goals for the next 12 months. I even did the podcast episode about the practice of rewriting the goals for the year. And somehow I felt drawn to you, and I felt that you are the one among other people with whom I worked that time who can support me to actually achieve those things on my list. And those things were related with numbers as well, as we were going to buy a big piece of land. And our business grew so much, you know, in this time. But it was also about my personal development as a mother, as a wife, as, you know, me, myself, and relationship with my body, with my health. So it was a very holistic list. And I wanted to work with someone who will support me in a holistic way. Maybe not so much about details and tactics of the business, you know, how to write emails and how to launch a new course. This I already felt so full of that I could teach it myself almost. But I was really hungry for a deeper work and work related with thoughts thoughts and sentences which are keep coming back in an unconscious way, mm-hmm. sabotaging the success.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. This is what limiting beliefs do. Mm. They are sabotaging our success, also our happiness, whatever it is in life. I remember there was a real big breakthrough. It was about building your team. Mm-hmm. There was some special situation that where it was like it didn't let you go further on your path, but it was essential to grow this business that you have today. How would you describe this breakthrough?
Honestly, I went with so many breakthroughs with you that at some point I felt like each month new breakthrough because I came with the topic. I came with something which was like a challenge for me. And then during the session, I realized it is connected with some essential way of being in the world. And then also during the session, in a duration of 1 hour, we were traveling back to this time when it was installed in me, so to say, and sometimes traveling without really sharing the story, but more through emotional memories, more through the heart, which made it so powerful. And then after the session, I really felt like I am a different person. It is healed. So after the session, sometimes it was really even difficult for me to relate with who I was before, because it was like I became someone, not someone else or someone different, but I like kind of, it's just like snake leaving the skin, you know? Mm-hmm. I bet he's not related with the skin laying next to him anymore, although it used to be so close.
So for me, it's also like this on this journey that we are together on during the last 2 years, nearly 2 years. Many times I shed my skin and I never regret it. And I also never thought that this skin is like part of me anymore, you know? It's just like off and the new is coming. Yeah. And I guess the depth of the work that we did together made those changes so natural that it was just done. Yeah. Left behind exactly in the right place. This metaphor is so good because, you know, it used to serve me. But then during the session, I recognized many times and also probably also that time that it doesn't really serve me anymore. It's time to shed the skin and really become a new, grow a new set of supporting thoughts, feelings, sentences, like a new quality. So I'm still the same, but yet different. Mm. And when I came to you, I had one assistant with which I was going through some difficult, you know, cooperation. And it was just after I finished work with my really the first assistant, which was also a great lesson. Let me put it this way. Yeah. Great lesson. The first and the second challenging. And here I was, wanted to build a team and not having great experiences during the, you know, the 1 year of first attempts to have support. And also I never worked as a team member before. I always worked like maybe with someone, like both of us, but in a project that basically I created from scratch. So for me, it was really like standing on the edge of very deep water and you know you want to swim, you are ready to swim, but you have no idea how to swim and you are about to jump, yeah? So it's a lot of emotions, emotional work. I really recall the most powerful sessions that we had as diving through the sentences and through the words, because those are the tools of our beliefs, but really into the feelings, emotions, and ways of being.
Yes, that's completely true. Mm. For me, it always felt like we were working directly in the quantum field. There's such a special connection on a really high level. And it was like after each session, Maria did the next quantum leap and the next quantum leap.
Yes, exactly. It's like this. And I was also surprised at the beginning, just to be honest, because I had this belief that it needs to be hard and it needs to last long and many hours, weeks and years. And suddenly I experience how fast and how light change can be and how easily we can adopt the ways of being keeps coming back to me now as an expression. Yeah. As easily we can become a new version of ourselves, exactly like this snake, which is not like suffering, you know, while leaving the skin. I have no idea about the details of this process, by the way, but I imagine it's just something that it's installed in him, yeah, mm-hmm. in the snake. And in us also, we have this ability to change, to evolve, to, you know, ascend to the higher levels of our being. And especially nowadays, I feel it really strongly. And you being an energy coach, you are such a great support in this realm, so to say, because now changes are not done like they used to be, you know, coaching hardly on the belief for 1 year, going for therapy with all the respect to therapists, but it can be done in a much faster way, the way which leave you surprised, excited, and so light and joyful. So for me, always the feeling that I had at the end or after the session was the best explanation of what happened. Sometimes it was difficult for me to actually put this in words. The, you know, this after session impressions that you asked me to write all over again and I didn't. It was mainly because it was hard for me to actually describe what happened, but it was very easy for me to describe who I become or who I am now. And actually, the best proof of all this work is Agni, as it's, you know, the business that I run, as it's together as it's today. So it's this year, it will be multiple seven figures business. And so the last year we achieved the seven figure mark. And now we are just like going beyond this, and the team is now it's I think it's around 7 or 8 because it changes a little bit. So I'm sometimes losing the count, and we have so many clients with whom we can work on the different levels, like offering really affordable products, also cheap, but also those high-end clients. And for me, this is the biggest change, you know, coming back to the changes that I have in my life, thanks to working with you, because I gain back so much energy that it's possible for me to work on with my clients on a really high-touch services and high-touch courses. I mean that I'm really with them. I'm fully focused. I'm diving deep into their heads and hearts, sometimes for minutes, sometimes for longer periods. But basically, I do have an energy for this. Mm-hmm. Every person who did it in the past knows that this is the most energy-consuming task that we can have, to work one-on-one or with the group of clients, but in a deep connection. It really requires energy. And sometimes people are just burning all the energy in this kind of work, and it's not enough to develop the business. And I'm so blessed to be in a place where the business is developed, it grows, and it's really successful. At the same time, I do have energy to do what brought me to the business, to serve the people on a higher level at the first time. And by the way, being really well rewarded for my work, because they feel the effect and they feel the value, so they are happy to pay for the value. Exactly as you said in the podcast that I listened to you for the first time, that clients are so amazed by the effects that they will happily pay for it. And it's possible because you have you, and now I also feel it, I can use this energy to really serve them. It's not either this or this. It's not having successful business or working closely with the clients. As I now understand, it can be both successful business, which is run by successful team, my freedom team, and I myself being chillpreneur, so running my business in a relaxed way. For me, it means respecting my weak spots as well and really embracing my strengths, and have capacity to work with the clients with I love to work. Long answer.
Yes. I remember we also have VIP days twice a year. Yeah. And the first question I'm asking you is always, what have you achieved the past 6 months? And the last VIP day, you sent me 2 pages of what you achieved. And I was reading it and I thought, wow, and this is only 6 months.
Who is she?
This is something that really high achievers have. They are not aware of their successes. Mm-hmm. And it was very interesting. Also, how would you describe it when you answered this question, when you wrote all these things down you achieved? How did you make this feel?
First of all, I knew the VIP day is coming and I will be celebrating the success with you, which I really love. I even made a podcast episode about how fun is it to celebrate the success with someone who is fully there for you and really happy for every step that you take. It's such a beautiful experience to share this joy, and it's just pure joy. It's nothing about not enough, nothing about being jealous, nothing about good advice. It's just let's celebrate. It's really like the most beautiful moment during your wedding or when your child is born, that you are just pure joy. And I guess with being high achiever, sometimes it's hard to have those moments and to really embrace the things that I've done in the past. So I knew that the VIP is coming and I saw the questions and I just grab a notebook and I scratch the answers. And when I start to write them, it was like pouring through. And then many, you know, pages after, I realized, oh my God, so many. Yeah? And then I needed to rewrite it on my computer in order to send it to you. And it was like for the second time. And then we went through them for the third time. And I was like, yes. Wow, amazing, yeah? And really, such a short time, and at the same time, the time that I wasn't consumed by my work, that I really remember as a very fulfilling time as a wife, as a mom, you know, in our personal life, establishing a garden and, you know, preparing for building the house, so many topics and moments around those things. So it was not like I put all the eggs in one basket and I was focused on my work for 6 months to get things done. It was more like, yeah, let's have full life in every aspect. So full when I was in those moments of the day when I'm a mother of two kids, those with myself, those when I'm with my husband, and those when I'm working. It's this, I guess this is the something that I was attracted to very early on, to really make good use of the time that we are given. For me, it was always like this question, is it really enough to just sit and watch TV or, you know, just live this kind of boring life? I was always like sensing that it is a great gift and I should do something great with it. And having those 6 months being summed up like this and celebrated in your presence is really gives me this feeling that, yeah, I really lived rich life in the professional way, but also in the personal way. So I just have this very deep feeling of being satisfied, which is related with the achievements, but not based on the achievements.
Mm-hmm. You're not attached to it.
No.
And this is really great that we don't depend on our successes to feel good, that we know I am successful and I feel good anyway, no matter what happens. Also, if some things maybe don't go, we would like them to.
Yeah.
Not being attached to it, this is so important.
Yeah, like, you know, giving a really like an example of what does it mean. I remember writing my first book and then publishing it. It was huge thing for me, but I wasn't happy with the way it was published. So I was celebrating that it went out, but I was a little bit ashamed of how the book looked inside. It was just some typing things, but having this high achievement, you know, how high achievement mind, I was really eager to spot all the things that could be done better. So I did it for the second time. I went through the book and the whole process last very long. It was quite like a boring thing to do, but I wanted to publish the book in a way I wanted to be published. So I put a lot of heart and time into it and I made it happen. And I printed this time like 5,000 copies. Yeah. And I said, like, now I'm ready to be seen. I'm ready to be visible. Let's just celebrate, you know, the second edition of the book. And funnily enough, the book isn't best-selling book. It's just like drops are falling from this top, you know, like every day, 1, 2, 3 books are going from our shop into the world. So it's like slowly, but I do really have this big sense of success because I went back to the project for the second time. I did it the way I wanted to be done and I feel I'm complete. So the next steps, how many people will actually buy the book, read the book and benefit is just like a topping on the cake. But the main work is done. I can be asked, did you use your talent in spreading this knowledge? And I can say, yes. Mm-hmm. It's like this, it gives me this calm feeling. Yeah, I did my part. And now it's up to people if they want to buy or not.
Mm-hmm. This is so wonderful. And this is when you're completely in flow.
Yes. Yes, this is like a secret, you know, of being in the flow, that you're actually doing the things that you love, that you feel are very important for you to become the person that you know you can be. It's like really becoming you. It's not becoming someone else. It's really like tuning in to the success that you are from the very first moment of your being, meaning, you know, the conception phase, yeah? You becoming you, merging from your mother and father into you. This is a pure success. And I really understand this more and more, that the only thing we need to do is to heal and release all the things that are blocking us from our greatness, that it's really like given, imprinted installed in us, yeah, with our dharma, with our calling, with our so-called duties. It's just letting go of all those things that are stick to us. Mm-hmm. And for me, it wasn't, for some time, it wasn't like shedding the skin. It was more like shedding the things that stick to my skin before, yeah? All the rubbish and then the skin itself and then regrowing the next one because we are keep evolving. So it's amazing now in this place where I am now, it's amazing how I feel this process of self-development and how it became so light and so effortless instead of this fighting mode that really made my arms so tired.
Mm-hmm. When you think about these 2 years, what was a very special breakthrough for you? Was there something you say, this was outstanding for me?
I really had so many of them with you because usually for the session, I was coming with the list of at least 2 or 3 different topics. And very soon it was clear on which one we need to work today. So the most sensitive one and the biggest and more powerful breakthrough. But the one that I really remember well and it resonates with my clients, with my community, was the one related with witch wound, I call it, like this, quoting someone else who came with this term for the first time, but basically feeling that you have a great knowledge for which you may be punished. So it's better to not show up, not being visible with this knowledge, because the consequences of this can be really fatal. And I'm meaning this, like you can lose your life. This kind of, I remember that I connect with this fear of losing life because I know something. And I often see it in my clients' eyes. I see that they know. I see that they have this intuition that they know how to cook, how to make soups, how to use herbs, how to be independent, how to really cherish their freedom. But there is like a big fear in their eyes, which is beyond this time that we are now. It's like from different reality almost. And they are so scared to even say in their families that they are into Ayurveda, which is really about independence, freedom, and healing. Independence from all limitations. So starting from physical also, yeah? But having your own mind and having your own wisdom guiding you. And I see it in them and I didn't know how to address it. And once I heal it in me, as much as it was possible at this moment, because I believe in constant healing is more like a peeling the next layer of onion. It's not like done forever. It's just, yeah, let's see what will come next. Yeah, it's more like this joyful adventure. It really brought this, I guess, quite around the same time, this symbol of lighthouse came to me that I really like. I managed to somehow combine those things. So fear of being seen with being a light. And actually the fact that you may like it or you may not like it, but you are, just creating this light for others. Mm-hmm. People are actively searching for this light. They are making use of this light. They are coming closer. And I found this concept very healing for my clients and it made me so, even today before our meeting, one of the entrepreneurs or businesswoman, she related to this concept of being a lighthouse for her coworkers and her her daughters. And I was like, yeah, it's such a big, powerful picture that it works inside of them and it helps them to heal this a very old fear of being seen and share your light, because what can be more on the other side? Yeah. Like hiding from being seen and being a lighthouse. Those are just like 2 aspects of the same quality. Yeah. So I guess this was the breakthrough that I really remember because it's still very vital in my community. It's still really like circling around. And also today I was told, I heard this, my client was saying that during the lockdown, she was listening a lot to me and she said something like, you were such a great thing during the lockdown. Yeah. She put it this way. And I remember that time I was really exploring the lighthouse concept, lighthouse for business, lighthouse for the families. We had the summit together. You were a part of this summit, yeah, being a lighthouse and later on being a lighthouse for business. So basically exploring this concept of sharing the light in the way that you are comfortable, you know, smaller, bigger, but really seeing the lights as a sign of hope and like a guiding light so we can come back home safely from the disturbed sea. And it was such a powerful for us, for all of us that time. And it still is. And because although the time maybe is not so overpowering now, but still major changes are going on. And for many people, this is a time of question. Do they want to be free or they want to be obedient? Yeah, follow the rules and paying the highest cost, or choosing the way of following their instinct, their inner wisdom and inner guidance, and being in a way, I wouldn't say against, but in a minority, so to say.
What you described with the witch wound, these are experiences from former lives. Our soul has experienced so much. Mm. And I completely agree with you that especially when we are in this high consciousness, we have this already since a long time. But to protect ourselves, we keep hiding until we are ready to say, okay, now I let my light shine no matter what.
Yes.
And in your case, you could step out of this completely.
Mm.
We healed it. And then you can let your light shine. Then there's nothing that can hold you back.
Yes. Really, it's like this. Yeah. Yes. And thanks to those experiences, such a podcast episodes are possible, because I really admire the self-confidence of women sharing their successes before. And I always want to tap into this feeling. How is it when you are saying such a great things about yourself in such an easygoing way that it's not perceived as being proud or brag about your success? It's just the way you are. And you are very casual, very normal, but at the same time, very joyful and successful. And how to really have those two qualities of being humble and successful. Mm-hmm. It was always fascinating for me, being an, you know, student of Ayurveda, which is such an ancient tradition. It requires being humble, but at the same time, I want to be successful and want to have my share in this. So how to really merge those two kind of opposite qualities into one beautiful story about living a joyful life. This is the story of living a joyful life. And I'm so happy that I can share this story with you today.
And you mastered it all the way.
Yeah. And it's just the beginning. You know what they're saying? I bet you feel the same, yeah? That after all of these things that we've done for ourselves and now for our clients and in our businesses, we are just about to start.
Yes. I'm now in my sixth year of business. Mm-hmm. And it's exactly like you say. It's we keep developing, we keep discovering new things, and being then in a position of serving more people and contributing to the development of the global consciousness. This is really my personal mission. Mm. It's what I say with each limiting belief. Somebody is breaking through. This person is raising the global consciousness. And this is why I love my work so much. This is the higher sense I see behind it and how I want to serve the world.
Yeah, that's why it's so special to have you today in this role of someone who is asking the questions, because you're actually asking about the success, which is also like supported through our work. It's the success that I have, the breakthroughs that I felt, they have direct impact on the clients, thousands of clients who are reading the emails, going through the courses. And in this way, it's really start to be seen. I mean, it's always seen, because for this particular person, it's her life, it's her universe, yeah? It doesn't have to be 10 people along with her. It's just her life and it's perfectly enough. It's such a brilliant joy to have more lives changed, inspired, touched through those powerful metaphors, wisdom, and in my case, bringing Ayurveda back to life in this easy to understand and easy to make use of form.
This was an amazing conversation with you, Maria, and I can't wait to see you further grow and where your path in this life is guiding you to. We once made a journey in the future, like 20 years, and I remember your pictures. These were wow.
Yeah.
So we are ready to expect Maria on stage, shining her full light and being a lighthouse, really, to the world.
Thank you. Thank you, Elizabeth, for this beautiful space today so I can open up so honestly and so, you know, in having this confidence and this like calmness at the same time. It's such a beautiful experience that I have during each of our sessions, and we could really did it again, yet again during the podcast here. So I'm very grateful for this. And yes, I heard the future is bright. And the good news is I'm ready for it.
That's really wonderful.
Thank you so much for being here today with me.
Thank you, and wishing you all the best, lots of joy and love and peace on your way, wherever it's guiding you to.
Yeah, same for you. All the best.
Thank you.
Dziękuję Ci za wspólnie spędzony czas. Wejdź na stronę agni-ayurveda.pl/76, gdzie znajdziesz notatki do tego odcinka podcastu. A jeśli prowadzisz holistyczny biznes albo przymierzasz się do stworzenia takiego biznesu czy też przekształcenia Twojej firmy tak, żeby ona działała w sposób holistyczny, w sposób, który szanuje Twoje ograniczenia i gra Twoimi a sami w rękawie, to bardzo serdecznie zapraszam Cię przede wszystkim do 6-miesięcznego programu online Ayurveda Business Coaching, na który zapisy startują już niebawem. Będzie to druga edycja tego programu, który tworzy nową jakość w Twoim biznesie, po to, żebyś mogła go prowadzić w bardziej całościowy sposób i żebyś mogła jeszcze bardziej niż do tej pory czerpać z rozwoju zawodowego i z rozwoju Twojej firmy, jak ze ścieżki, która prowadzi Cię do rozwoju także na płaszczyźnie duchowej. Serdecznie zapraszam, pod tym nagraniem znajdziesz link, gdzie poznasz wszystkie szczegóły. Dziękuję Ci, że jesteś, dziękuję Ci, że słuchasz i przy okazji dziękuję swojemu głosowi, że jest i nam wszystkim dzielnie służy. Tej jesieni miałam okazję przekonać się, że to coś, za co też warto, żebym była wdzięczna. Tym bardziej cieszę się, że mogę do Ciebie znowu mówić i regularnie nagrywać podcast. Wszystkiego dobrego, kochana, dla nas na kolejny rok wspólnych odkryć w ramach podcastu Agni Ayurveda. Trzymaj się ciepło.